Okay, guys, welcome to Cowie's Girl, episode 2 on the beginner's guide to riding a motorcycle. So today we're out in beautiful weather. Looks like it's about to rain sooner or later, but hey, we'll see. So anyway, welcome to episode 2 of the beginner's guide to ride. Now, first episode we discussed all the parts around the bike. And today we're going to actually get on the bike, move the bike, start the bike, and possibly get into first gear just to get the bike rolling. So, the first most important thing to do, is how to properly get on the bike. Some people like to come on the right-hand side, those who don't know, but that's wrong. Always on the left-hand side because your bike tilts in more. Make sure when you get on the bike, your right leg, for me, it's best even or close to where my fairing lies for this bike. Each bike is different, but you want to kind of guesstimate. And your knee is going to swing right in between here and your leg over. If you go too far back, you're going to have to try to swing over a higher part of your bike. You don't really want to. So keep it close, knee up and over. Here we go. There we go. Once you saddle or sat on the bike, lift the bike with your left leg or push away till both of your feet are touching the floor. Adjust your body to where it's nice and even, feet flat on the floor or as flat as you can get it on the floor. Don't stress yourself out because some bikes are way taller than other bikes. Now, once you first get on the bike, feel your balance. Let me turn this off real quick, save some battery. Get your balance. Look down for the kickstand. I like to keep my hand on the brake. Look down on the kickstand. Flip it up. Feet flat on the floor. That's the first thing they're going to show you how to get in the motorcycle class. That's the first thing they're going to show you when you get on the actual course for the Motorcycle Safety Foundation. Next they're going to ask you is just feel the weight of the bike in between your legs. Let you get used to what it is. You don't want to overswing the bike too much, but just enough to feel the balance of the bike. Right? At first, hold on to it. Don't let go. Because when you go to the course, you're going to be using their vehicle, not yours. Next they're going to ask you to do is rock the bike back and forth. Everything is in neutral. You know you're in neutral if the engine is off is because the bike is rolling. If you were in any gear, your engine has a lockdown and you won't be able to roll forward or backward whatsoever. So, I'm going to show you the side view here on how to rock back and forth. All I'm doing is sitting back and then pushing forward. Like you're about to run forward or you're taking like a giant leap double-legged forward. But your feet never leave the ground. Going forward. And then when I go backward, I sit back on the bike. Sit back down. Up. Back down. They're going to ask you to do this for a few minutes to get used to the whole entire weight of the bike. Once that is done, the next step they're probably going to show you is walking the bike forward and backing the bike with the engine turned off, also in neutral position. So when you walk the bike forward, we don't just stand up and start walking the bike. It just does not work. You have to make sure your feet are flat, your butt is nice and comfy on your saddle, and you're using your body weight and momentum to move forward. As I go forward, I'm going to back the bike up here so you can start, so you can watch a little bit of the movement. I'm going to lower this. Here we go. So first step, push your body forward using both of your legs to push forward, and then just walk it. And then going backwards is push on your toes back and then walk backwards. Use your brake to stop. Again, push forward, use your heels, and then go heel to toe. That's the way I go for it, so my feet are at contact on the floor all the time. Going backwards, push on the toes, and then toe to heel. Going forward again, push off your heels and then roll heel to toe. Going backwards, push off your toes back and then walk toe to heel. That's for me. Each person has their own different things. A lot of people push forward and they flat foot the thing. To me, that feels a little rough because you're flat footed. And some people sometimes just like to do it on their toes only, backing only in toes, or moving forward only in toes. But for me, that doesn't give me the optimal grip for the whole entire ground. Just in case if you're on a slippery surface or a lot of gravel, using the toe to heel technique, walking backwards or walking forward will give you the best grip to the ground without you slipping or sliding. So the next part they're going to show you, once you rock back and forth and walk the bike forward and walk the bike backwards, is to start the bike. Here's the first step. They're going to have this kill switch off. That's their thing. Must shut off the kill switch at all times. So when you get on the bike, I'm going to take a look down here. My key is in off position, not in lock, because I've been moving the bike back and forth. To safely turn on your bike, kill switch on, look at the ignition key, on position, your tack is going to kick into gear and you'll hear little sounds like that. That's just your engine and everything ready to go. Make sure your bike is in neutral. Nearly every bike has a green light for neutral, and new bikes have the gear indicators. So for neutral, on a gear indicator, usually will either say N or zero because it's not a gear. You want to make sure you're there. Again, checking you're able to go back and forth. Now that's down, key is turned, I'm in neutral. For my safety, doesn't matter where I am, as a peace of mind, I always hold on to my brake, even though I don't need it if I'm on a flat road. Just for my safety and my comfort, I always hold on to the front brake. And then let's look down here. Let's see if you can see that. Down here where my thumb is located, that is the electric start. So I'm just going to press that. You'll hear a little crank like a car, and your bike will turn on. Aha. And now, that's how you turn on your bike. To turn off your bike, you just go in reverse. At the motorcycle safety school, they're going to ask you to hit the kill switch first. That will shut the engine off, and then turn off the bike, take the key out. My alarm might go off, but who knows. Okay, here we go. Back on. There's the alarm, but don't worry, it's not going to go off. Kill switch on. Key on position, everything is cycling through, hand on brake, and kick the bike on. Now, next part they're going to ask you to do is feel the bike vibrating in between your legs for you to feel the weight difference when the engine is on. Then some courses might ask you to actually walk it back and forth just a little bit to get used to it. Just a little bit with the engine on. Next thing they're going to ask you to do is shift into first gear. How do we shift into first gear? Very easy. Nearly every single motorcycle has the same shifting capabilities. This is what I mean. Shifting positions, most of them. It's in neutral, you go one down. That's gear one. To get to gear two, it's a full click up. Gear three goes up. Gear four goes up. Gear five, gear six goes up. Once again, in neutral, gear one, push your toes down. To get to gear two, go underneath the shifter, lift up to gear two, gear three, gear four, gear five, and gear six. Some bikes go only up to gear five. A lot of bikes go up to gear six. It's all depending on what you have. Now, you can't just move your feet up and down to do the shifting. You have to follow a specific format. As we discussed, the clutch lever is your key element. Now, there are bikes that go, you know, shiftless clutches that's just right on the foot and has to do with the blipping of the throttle, but this is for every other bike that doesn't have that, or any bike that you're going to start with at the motorcycle school. This is what they're going to give you. Open your clutch or press in your clutch. Look down at your shifter. I'm going to lift my leg, put it on my heel on the peg, push down. You'll feel, you'll hear a pop and possibly a little jerk forward, but that's okay. There it is. Once again, I'm going to shift it to neutral, which is a half shift up. My toe goes underneath, lift, and take a look. The neutral light is on. Going back into first gear, my toes are on top. Watch my gear tech and the neutral light holding on to the clutch, and I have my hands on the brake. Push down, and there you go. Neutral light disappears, and first gear goes on. Once you've mastered that a little bit, right, lift it half up, then I can let go of the clutch and let go of the brake. Anytime you shift in a stop position, please make sure your hand is on the brake for your safety. Here we go. First gear, open the clutch or press the clutch in, look down, heel on the foot peg, foot on top, push down. You'll hear that pop. It's okay. First gear is on. Neutral light is gone. Now, next step is they're going to ask you to find the sweet spot of your motorcycle. So I'm going to let go of this at this point. Now I'm not worried about anything else. Sweet spot is just slowly letting go of the clutch to see where your engine engages to move forward. In the beginning, they're going to ask you to do this just to get the bike moving forward a little bit and then press the clutch in again. Close the clutch or open or release the clutch and then depress the clutch. Once again, slowly release the clutch till you feel the bike moving and then press the clutch. Here's the hard part, to find that access point or the quote unquote sweet spot for your bike to move. So once again, I'm going to look up top. My feet are flat on the floor. Lightly, I'm going to use two fingers because this is a shorty lever. A shorty lever. So here we go. Lightly, all the way through, and then back in. As you can see, I'm just not letting go of the clutch, because if I do that, oh boy, this whole entire thing will pop. Here's an example. I'm going to hold on to my brake. If you let go too fast, you're going to bounce, and the engine will shut off. All right? And look, now the bike is in a locked position. It won't roll forward or backwards, because the engine is in gear, and if the engine is not running, it will lock itself. Now I'm going to turn the bike back on, back into neutral. You could turn it on in first gear, no big deal, but for your sanity and sane of mind at this point, at a very beginning phase, put it into neutral at a stop position. Here we go, holding my brake, press the electric start, bike is back on. Brake is on, clutch is in, looking, heel down, toe on top, press down, let go of the brake, gently and slowly release the clutch till you're moving forward, then press back in. You're going to do this a bunch of times. They're not going to just let you say, okay, you got it three times, let's go. They're going to have you do it for like 2 to 5 minutes. You want to do it as much as you can. All right, as much as you can. If you feel like you're out of control, press on your front brake. Make sure your feet are flat on the floor. Here we go, forward, backwards. All right, just a little bit, and back. Again, focus again. Take a look there. Down we go. Slightly. Okay. Once you've mastered that, they're going to have you start the bike and start walking it down your track. Only in first gear, no throttle, right? Because the throttle gets you going. So I'm going to back up a little bit here for the camera so you can see. And now I'm going to walk the bike by releasing the clutch. Here we go. Both hands on, fingers on the brake just in case. Slowly let the engine take you and walk with it going forward. Let me do that again. Back it up. On my toe to heel, Once again, here we go. Start from back here. All right, release the clutch slowly and start walking. Releasing it slowly. You never want to completely let it out, otherwise it will pop and the front end might jump upwards and you don't want that. And the bike will definitely stall out on you, right? We don't want that. Now, properly dismounting the bike. First major thing we do as a beginner. At the motorcycle course, they might have you keep it in first gear and just put a kill switch on it. You have two options. Do it that way. Leave it in first. Let the kill switch go and then turn off the key. And then put your kickstand down. Or the better option, which I like, that doesn't engage the kill switch. Or you can still engage the kill switch, but after the fact, put my brake on. Half click up. Back in neutral, so I can let go of the clutch and my mind is worry-free. Then I turn off the bike, kill switch on, look down, put all the way to my right foot, feel for the kickstand, put it down. Now, getting off the bike, we already tilted in. My feet are ahead of the kickstand, right? I'm gonna lift off my toe and get off the bike. Right leg is gonna do the same spot as getting on, and reverse knee is gonna go where the rider just sat. Over and swing and done. Once again, to get on, foot kind of matches with my frame slider. Each bike is different, so you kind of gotta find your spot. And then go forward, lift over, and on. To get off, foot flat, lean the bike over, use this as your left leg as your balance, right leg to kick off, and go over. All right? There we go. So ladies and gentlemen, this will conclude episode 2 of the Beginner's Guide to Riding a Bike. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, if you like the video, please go ahead and click on the thumbs up button that's down there. If you have any questions, comments, please go ahead and type it down below, and I will gladly get back to you as soon as possible. And of course, don't forget to go and click that little red box on the bottom and click that subscribe button.